Stop, Holmes!
Is that you, Watson?
Yes, of course it is. And you almost killed me.
Nonsense. I was aiming for the vases.
Blindfolded?
Watson, quiet, please. I'm trying to concentrate. Ah, Lestrade. What is it this time?
He can see me. Well, here it is, and it's a good one, Mr. Holmes. A gentleman by the name of Peter Carey, also known as Black Peter, has been murdered.
A sailor, most probably.
What happened here?
Oh, Mr. Holmes, how could you?
It's the only exercise I've had all week. A grateful client from Limoges sent me a vase collection this morning. I couldn't think of a better use for it.
You're out of your mind.
I missed 4 out of 10.
Given you were blindfolded, that was very good. Can I have a try?
Am I the only sane one here?
I suppose that Watson is right, Inspector. A little brain work would be preferable now. Do please tell us more about Black Peter.
Peter Carey, born in 1845 and 50 years old. An ambitious sort, he achieved much success in seal and whale hunting around Scandinavia. Retired in 1884 with a small fortune. He invested his money in a property called Woodman's Lee, near Forest Row in Sussex. It was where he lived for 6 years, and where he was found dead yesterday.
Has the investigation already begun?
Yes and no. In fact, this crime is so mysterious that I would prefer you to join me down there.
Give me half an hour to prepare, Inspector.
Take your time and join me there. I have to go through the yard first. The merry men struck again.
What have they done this time?
They robbed a powder reserve. I'll meet you at Woodman's Lee, Mr. Holmes.
I should help Mrs. Hudson here. I also have several appointments that I must keep this afternoon.
I shall go alone, then.
You go along to Peter Carey's house. Mrs. Hudson and I will take care of the mess you've made here.
Oh, what a mess! What a terrible mess!
A map of London and the surrounding area. It could be useful.
Hey!
Holmes, I'm over here. Come on.
Inspector Lestrade, when will you remove my husband's body? It's sacrilegious to leave him here like this.
As soon as we can, Mrs. Carey, I assure you. Allow me to introduce you to Mr. Sherlock Holmes. He's a detective. No doubt you've heard of him. I'll wait for you in front of the cabin, Mr. Holmes.
My condolences, Mrs. Carey.
Thank you, Mr. Holmes.
Madam, can you tell me if you saw or heard anything unusual upon the night of the murder?
At 2 o'clock in the morning, I heard a terrible scream. I thought nothing of it then. He would scream all the time when he was drunk.
Can you please tell me what occurred on the evening of the murder?
Well, Peter got drunk in the evening. He was in such a terrible temper. Usually, whenever that happened, he'd stay all night drinking in his cabin before passing out.
Do you remember at what time you found your husband's body?
In the morning, at around 7 o'clock. I noticed the cabin door was open, but I didn't go in to take a look, for I knew my husband would not have liked it. At around 10 o'clock, I dared to glance in through the door and... Oh, dear...
Was your husband accustomed to receiving visitors?
Oh, no, I don't think so. I mean, he didn't really have many friends. We lived quite an isolated life here, after his retirement.
You have indeed suffered a great loss, Mrs. Carey. Nevertheless, I believe it will be less of a burden for you soon.
Yes. Life with Peter was never easy. But he was still my husband.
He was different, wasn't he, when you first met him upon your return from Plymouth?
Yes, Mr. Holmes. Oh, my goodness, but how do you know about that?
You undertook a pilgrimage to the Cathedral of Santiago de Compostela when you were young. That much is evident from the rosary in your hand. The shortest route for the pilgrim from England to Spain is from Plymouth. I believe that you met Peter Carey as a young sailor there, and you married him soon afterwards.
That is indeed what happened, Mr. Holmes. How extraordinary.
Thank you, madam.
Peter Carey's body is inside the cabin. We took care not to touch anything.
The door is locked.
Wait just a moment, Mr. Holmes, and I'll open it. I locked it yesterday to ensure that no one should enter the cabin and tamper with the evidence.
Ah, good thinking.
Hello, hello, hello.
What is it, Lestrade?
It seems to me that someone has tried to force it, Mr. Holmes.
Let me see. These scratches are fresh. You're right. Someone tried to force open the door.
I swear these scratches were not here yesterday.
Now, a mysterious visitor came here last night.
Well, he's not the man for the job. This lock is not a difficult one.
Perhaps he did not have the right tool. It seems that the garden was well maintained. These footprints appear to be quite large. What a terrible way to die. This place is not covered with dust, like the rest of the shelf. An object was taken from here. It was larger than a book. A box or a small chest, perhaps. The tooth of a sperm whale, probably from one of Peter Carey's catches. This man is in his 50s, yet he still looks quite strong. Peter Carey was fully dressed. He was not caught by surprise. It is possible that he knew his murderer. Peter Carey was impaled to the wall by a whaling harpoon.